Democrats grill members of President Donald Trump's cabinet who are on Capitol Hill to defend the president's 2020 budget requests. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi digs into today's heated hearings over how to best spend American tax dollars. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Lauren. The Trump administration says they're devoting unprecedented amounts to school choice. People could get tax credits by donating to scholarship funds. Those, in turn, would help kids go to Catholic or other private schools. Now, this 2020 budget would cut 5% from non-defense spending while still adding $1.1 trillion to the deficit.
This budget attacks the most vulnerable in this nation.
Democrats hammer the Trump administration for boosting defense spending while making other cuts.
So why in the world are you asking for $750 billion for defense, in contrast to the enormity of the amount of billions of dollars that you're cutting from education, environment, Medicaid, Medicare?
The president's budget would drop $2 trillion from healthcare spending, including on medical research.
No agency can spend well when they don't live in a resource-constrained world.
The acting budget director defends cutting 10% from the Department of Education. He says some programs just don't work.
We believe this budget fully funds what is necessary to continue to educate our children. We have $50 billion.
So that we can continue falling behind South Korea, China, other competitors around the world in our education standards? Is that what you would like
it's
to continue to
raise your vote? One of the reasons why we are putting forward a different type of proposal. We have $50 billion in school choice tax credits that can be done at both the public level or at the private level. It's a paradigm shift that we think is important.
The 2020 budget would double the D.C. Opportunity Scholarship, which helps poor D.C. kids go to Catholic and other private schools.
Our view is that parents and families, states and localities can often do a better job.
Congress does hold the power of the purse.
This administration's budget is dead on arrival in the House.
This year's budget doesn't include last year's language to stop certain abortion providers from receiving federal funds. The appendix, which will come out later, includes normal pro-life riders like banning funds from going to most abortions. Now, the president promised to veto any spending bill that gets rid of these pro-life protections. Lauren?
Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi. Thank you, Jason.